This is the movie news as brought to you by me, Generally Nerdy, right here on the channel, Generally Nerdy, of whatever platform you might be watching on, probably YouTube. If you want to see the entire episode, the full news show, then follow the top link in the description, again, assuming you're on YouTube. Or if you are not, then check out youtube.com/generallynerdy, generallynerdy.net. Those are places to go do the thing. Let's get into the news before I lose my breath. Kicking things off in movies, we have a big follow-up. We have a bunch of follow-ups, but we're starting things with a large one. Dune, the second movie, we're assuming we're getting that far. So Denis Villeneuve has said recently in an interview with an Italian magazine that the focus is going to be shifting from Paul to Chani in the second movie if he gets to make the second movie. Now, there was a little bit of a shift in the original book that happened once we got to the point where Chani enters the story, but being as Zendaya is already in all of their marketing, it doesn't seem like that is going to be where the shift happens. So I'm interested to see. There is a possibility they can pull this off. It doesn't, is a really slim possibility. That's all I'm saying. So we'll be keeping close eye on this. Our next follow-up has to do with the Spawn movie that is perpetually in production somewhere. So there is a new writer attached to the project. So Todd McFarlane has handed over writing capabilities, though it sounds like he's still holding onto that director's seat for dear life. Brian Tucker has been brought on to rewrite the existing script. So it sounds like he's going to be telling the same story. He's just going to make it work a little bit better. According to a couple of firsthand accounts, it's not the best script ever. Of note here, before he was brought in to rewrite Spawn, he was a writer for Broken City with Mark Wahlberg and Russell Crowe, so that's pretty big. Also, he's working on the Fugitive reboot, so also pretty big. So it sounds like we have a coherent writer back on the writer's seat. I mean, I'm a big fan of Todd McFarlane, but again, from the sounds of things, it sounded like there was a hot mess on paper that Jamie Foxx and company were all signed on to be a part of, so this is probably a good thing. So next, we're talking about Free Guy, and Free Guy, this is an interesting situation. So this is going to be a real quick one. Free Guy will be released on HBO Max before it is ever released on Disney Plus. Even though technically Disney owns Free Guy, it's part of the Fox buyout. So there was an existing relationship between Fox and HBO, saying that all Fox properties, after they came out of theaters, and they are going to be in theaters exclusively for a minimum of some sort of time, which was not made clear, but there was a deal that said that once they are out of theaters, before they go to other platforms, they will go to HBO. So in this case, in the modern time, that means HBO Max. So it's going to be, again, an undisclosed amount of time, and it's going to be streaming exclusively on HBO Max after it has left theaters and before it goes to Disney Plus. So it's a very, very strange situation. It seems, though, if this does become a franchise, that will not be the case going forward. And it sounds like that is the thing. That's another rumor that we talked about online, is that there is a possibility this could become a franchise. We're not going to address the rumor in the show because I don't think there's enough time of it existing for this to... Anyway, moving right along. Our next piece has to do with Toxic Avenger. This one is also very quick. We have the announcement that they have officially wrapped on principal photography. So that's huge. We are that much closer to seeing the Toxic Avenger remake from Legendary Pictures. Wow, that is such a weird thing to say. But then we're moving sections. We don't have any trailers necessarily to speak of, so we're going right into the news, and we have an announcement that there's going to be a second Cruella movie. Why? it seems that the posturing of Emma Stone potentially threatening to sue Disney for the same reasons that Scarlett Johansson sued Disney has worked out in her benefit, at least. The jury is still out on Scarlett Johansson's benefit. But Emma Stone is definitely benefiting from this because she just signed a contract that says she's going to play Cruella one more time, at least, in a second prequel. So it's a sequel to the prequel that still happens before the 101 Dalmatians. Maybe this will be how she starts to hate dogs, because that stinking movie made no sense in the context of it being a prequel to 101 Dalmatians. I'm ranting. We're moving on. Our next piece has to do with Hotel Transylvania 4. This is an interesting one for a larger reason, but the first is the raw news, and the raw news is that Hotel Transylvania 4 is not going into theaters. Sony, who owns the rights, who is making the movie, is going directly to Amazon Prime with this. They have struck a deal for $100 million that says that this movie is going to be released exclusively on Amazon Prime for X amount of time. So Sony is one of the only large movie-making houses that does not have its own streaming service. So it's very interesting, what with the whole Crunchyroll Funimation thing from last week. Then we were unsure where Crunchyroll's content was going to be released. Well, now that they have this new relationship with Amazon, maybe that's how it goes. But they've also struck up relationships recently with Netflix, Amazon for other projects. So a lot still hangs in the balance. But I don't know, with them signing another deal with Amazon, it kind of lends one to believe maybe that's where Crunchyroll is going to go. And then you factor into the equation that Amazon is also looking to expand the Asian market. This is an animated thing. Crunchyroll and Funimation are anime. I don't know, just pieces might be falling. I don't know, let's figure it out, shall we? But that is all we have for movies. And that is all of the movie news that is worth talking about as far as the nerd sphere is concerned. If you want to see all of the other sections, again, top link in the description, generallynerdy.net, youtube.com/generallynerdy, Patreon.com/generallynerdy, all of the wonderful places. Thank you for joining me again, nerds. Before we go, always, always remember that if it's generally nerdy, it's probably here.